how to move your ant colonies from a test tube into a nest, or a nest to a nest, or out of a nest into a test tube. Moving your ant colonies can be quite hard, definitely for beginner ant keepers. In this video, I'm going to shine a light, literally, on moving your ants, and I will teach you everything I know. We will break this video down in several parts. Moving your ants from test tube to test tube, moving your ants from test tube to nest, and moving your ants from nest to nest. Use the timestamps to navigate to the part you have a question about. And while you are down here, hit that subscribe button for more ant content. Without further ado, let's start with the question I get asked most. How to move ants from a test tube into a new test tube. The main reasons why people want to move their ants out of a test tube is because of mold in the test tube, or your test tube has run out of water. The mold isn't a huge problem, but no water is. There are a few ways to move your ants into a new test tube. I will start with the technique I recommend most and use myself plenty of times. It's connecting a fresh test tube to an ant setup. This can be in a large container that acts as an outworld, or you can connect a test tube with tubing to the other test tube. Please don't tape two test tubes together. This will rarely work, and there are easier methods. This method is a variation on the tubs and tubes method. Don't worry too much if the ants don't move straight away. As you can see here, my Chromatogaster colony has completely dry tube and does not want to move into the fresh tube. This is not a problem, because the ants can drink from the fresh test tube and get their water that way. You can cover up or heat the new test tube to encourage the ants to move in. I often do this when moving ants by using my mini outworlds. Some tutorials will state that by blasting the ants with light makes them move easier. In my experience, this step only works if you keep your ants really dark and make the new test tube really dark. Species like Lazy's Niger can't care less about light and won't move because of light intensity. The next step is a little more advanced. Basically, you attach a fresh test tube to an outworld and tap the ants into the outworld. Now, the ants have nowhere to go and will settle in the fresh test tube. I don't recommend this step because the ants can escape if you don't do it right. For larger colonies, I use this step all the time. I put PTFE all around the lid so no ants will escape the outworld. Make sure you tap really hard the first time. I generally flick the test tube with my finger. If you don't tap hard enough, the ants will hold on, making it very hard to tap them out. I know it looks bad, but I can confirm with the experience of other ant stores that we never lost a colony by moving them this way. In the community, I asked around, and this was the most preferred way of moving ants according to other ant keepers. The third step I will mention is stepping over the ants directly into a new tube. Now, this step I absolutely don't recommend and should be used as a last resort. Basically, you put in the test tube on top of each other and flick the top one very hard. The queen, brood and eggs will all fall into the fresh test tube. This method has a lot of risks and should not be used for beginners. If you have no other option, then you should do it. Large colonies might not all fall and escape. Brood might not be transferred, and something that happened to me once, the queen fell next to the tube onto the ground. There's a lot of risk of moving your ants by tapping them, so I would recommend the previous method. Next, we have moving ants from a test tube into a nest. This is a lot easier than you think. There are a few ways of doing it, but let me explain to you how I do it. Like I've done a lot of times before, I attach a test tube to the setup. I'll leave a link to all these videos in the description where you can see me moving the ants. Now, this method does not always work. I think that can mean two things. One, the nest conditions are not good enough, and two, the ants don't want to move yet. Conditions are easy. Provide good humidity and make sure the nest is heated. Heat ensures that colonies move pretty fast, definitely exotic species. If you are unsure when to move your ants, I made a video on that as well. Link in the top right corner. If you really need to move your ants, you can use the same tricks with the test tube. Tap the ants into an outworld and attach a new nest. The ants have nowhere to go but the nest, so they will settle in there. Again, by attaching the test tube to the setup, your ants will move, eventually. Alright, moving on to moving ants from nest to nest. Let's say your ants are in a small nest and you want to move them into something bigger. Personally, I don't have much experience with this. I only moved my Nicobranthus from nest to nest. I did that by attaching the new nest to the setup. Make sure the conditions in the nest are optimal. Let the old nest dry out and take it off the heat. If everything goes right, most ants will move out of the old nest. Then, you take off the nest and tap the remaining ants into the outworld. Right now, I don't see another good way of doing it. Moving ants can be fast, but usually it's very slow. Don't rush the ants. The ants will always choose what's best for them. Forcing the ants is not something I like to do, and neither should you. If you still have problems moving your ants, go ask in forums or Discord servers. Over there, experienced ant keepers can help you out. I hope you liked this video and learned something about ants. With selling ants, I moved over 50 colonies into a new test tube, so I think my advice was somewhat valid. If you have any extra tips or tricks, leave them in the comments. Thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know what tutorial you want to see next. Bye.